Hello and welcome to this video. Today we will be adding motorization to this Lazy Susan using some clever 3D printed parts and some basic electronics. I already had this Lazy Susan, but if you want to get one cheap, there's lots of them for cheap in IKEA. For the basic concept, instead of adding the motor directly to the plate, I decided to challenge myself and make the plate detachable from the support. So I will be making a system that allows the plate to clip into the motor socket and be detached whenever we need it. So for the electronics, I used a normal DC motor, but as you can see from the video, the spinning motion is far too fast and far too weak for us to be able to move this plate around. So we will need to use some gears. In this example, the big gear has 3 times more teeth than the small one, meaning that when we turn the big gear 1 time, the smaller gear will make 3 turns. And of course, it also works for the opposite. Now, using this basic concept, we'll be able to turn a fast spinning motor into a low motion that has a lot more torque. There are motors available on the market that already have the gear converters built in, so all you need to do is wire it up and you get a low turning shaft on the opposite end. Now, speaking about the mechanical pieces, I 3D printed all the parts using some matte PLA filament. Some pieces were too big, so I had to slice them in CAD and glue them later. And also to save time and filament, I cut out the stand of some 6mm MDF that I later painted before adding a final coat of lacquer. Now, as we are using a DC motor, to change its speed, we'll be using this little converter. That's really simple to wire up, and to change the speed, you only need to turn the potentiometer knob left or right. It's really simple and a lot easier than having to deal with stepper motors. Now I assembled all the electronics and glued the motor in place. All pieces can be attached with some bolts. Then we can add a nice knob for the potentiometer. And finally comes the trickiest part, mounting the big wheel onto the plate. So for that I removed the mechanism and used the 4 screw holes to get the center point of the mechanism. Then using that as a reference, I was able to mount the big gear. After that we can glue the motor to the stand. And now when we put the 2 pieces together, they should click and we should have a nice homemade rotating display. Now I'm really happy with the clicking mechanism, it works like a charm. You can really put the thing on the motor and it will spin, so that's really nice. However, even with the gear ratios we added, the motor is too weak at low speeds, so sometimes it blocks, and also the DC motor is very loud. And instead use some belt pulleys to get this motion, because the tolerances will be far more easier to handle. Or if you're really lazy, you can just use a drill to make the plate turn. But all in all, in my case, I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. I learned a lot of stuff about gears because I had never worked with them before. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and leaving a like, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!